Hello students, welcome back. So in the last class we have studied about example of the swing in different ways, like inheritance or by the association also we have studied. So for today's class we have to study some classes of swing, like J label, J button, J radio button and all. So that is our topic for today's class. Okay. Fine. So without further ado, let's discuss about J label. So what label means? Label means it is a label in the form of text. We can get it on the display, means in the output window you can see that label. It is of kind string. Fine. So in the swing package, means as you know, we have to import the packages like Java, okay, import java x dot swing dot star. There is a J label is there. Fine. In the previous example I had shown a button, so let's discuss little more about these things. So now J label means it is the object of J label class, is a component for placing text in a container. So this class is used to place the text in a container, okay, and it is used to display single line of read only text that you can read. You cannot do any actions with this label, okay, you cannot write, so that you can read from the output window, okay. The text can be changed by an application, but a user cannot edit it directly. It means that the programmer can edit, the programmer can change that one, but user can only read that text. So that kind of label we can add to the container, that is J label. Okay, it inherits J component class. What it inherits? It inherits J component class. Okay, the now we have to see the constructor of J label. Before that, we have to see the class declaration of J label. Okay, fine. You can see now the class declaration of J label is public class J label, which can inherit from the J component. So that I have written public class J label extends J component. Okay, J label class can extends J component, and J label can implement two interfaces like swing constants and accessible. Okay, this is the class declaration of J label. Don't worry about this, I will write the code in a simple manner and I will execute it and I will show you. Fine. So what are the constructor for this J label? There are many constructors are there, so I am showing you these are the constructor which are used in J label class. Okay, the first constructor you can see is J label, which creates, fine, which creates a J label instance with no image and with an empty string for the title. Means if you use this J label constructor, you will get the output only with empty text. Means there is no output text in the window that you can see. And J label string, yes, if you use this constructor, you will get the string, whatever the string you have passed into the method body. Okay, and J label icon I, here you can create a icons like images you can put on the image, or small icons you can display on the output window. J label here in the last constructor you can see string s icon I int horizontal alignment. Here you will get the string and you will get the icon as well. Where the icon you need to place, that also we have to mention here, that is int horizontal alignment. This is integer constant. The constant is fixed here for the J label icon, that is horizontal alignment. Okay, so we will write a code and you can see how to use J label. And you know, I will use one of the string or one of the method from here, that is J label, and this one I can use, and this one also you can use if you want. So we start writing one code. Here you can see I have already written a code with some part. Getting my point here, what I have done is I have just used, okay, some basic packages. As you can see, import java.awt.event. This we have to import, so that to save the time, I have already written this point. Import java.awt.star. This is also needed. Import javax.swing.star for the swing. Okay, public class swing example 2. You can also inherit the frame by doing this. So I will clear this and I will write extends frame. That also you can do if you want, or if you want to create an instance of the frame, you can create frame f equals to new frame. That also you can do. Fine. So we are dealing with the J labels. Without further ado, I start J label. J label. Okay, you give the object name L or anything if you want. New J label. Okay, this is the first constructor you are seeing. Empty constructor is there. I would like to show only two constructors are there. Okay, if you want to check other constructor also, you can check, but it will take time. So I would like to show the first two constructor. J label L equals to new J label. Okay, so what I have to do, I have to add this component to the frame. Add L. Okay, if you have created object here, like you can see now, frame F. Okay, F equals to new J frame, then this component add means for this frame we need to add component L, means F dot add L we have to write. But what I have done, I have extended the frame, means there is no instance of the frame. Okay, so this is not needed. Just you can write add L, that's it. You can write add L. Fine. So set size. So this, what it does, set size means this will set the size of the frame width and height. Set layout, it will set the layout, like layout manager classes are there, flow layout, grid layout and all. So in the previous example, I have set the layout as null. Okay, now I have set flow layout. This layout will use automatic arrangements. Okay, it will arranges the components automatically. So I am taking flow layout. Why I am taking this? If I am not taking this one, so I have to set the bounds for all the components, like L dot set bounds, where I need to keep that label in the output screen that I need to write. If you are using button, B dot set bounds. So to overcome this, I have used set layout, visibility I had made true, public static void main, string args, new swing example 2. This is a constructor as we have having here. So now if you save this, you can write this code to write about J label. Okay, write this code now, because I will change this code only and I will execute and I will create a new program. So better way, you can write this point now up to whatever I am showing you, that you can note down now. Okay, fine. So we will execute this one. Okay, so I will execute this part right here. So I have already set the path. Just I need to write java c. What is our file name? File name is swing example 2. Swing example 2 dot java. Okay, some errors are there. I have to overcome those errors. Set layout error is there, so I have to correct that one. Okay, I will do that, don't worry. Okay, so here one parenthesis I have missed, so I will save this one. So now we'll check this one whether it will works or not. Fine, it is working now. So you have to compile. I have already compiled java c swing example 2 dot java. Now java swing example 2. Fine, you are getting the output right here. See, you are seeing the output, right? So whatever the output you are seeing, there is nothing in there in the output, only you can close, minimize and maximize, that's it. Fine. Why? Because if you see this code, in the constructor I have used default constructor, this part, this is default constructor. So the first method which I have showed in the PPT, right, you are seeing here, this is the default construct. This will not give any output. So I need to use second construct, that is string s. String s in the sense, you need to pass some string into this constructor. What I will do, I will pass You can new label, or you can write first. Okay, label. So if you save this and if you compile once again, and you will get the output as first label. So let's check. Fine, yes, you got the output first label you are getting, right? So this kind you can write the code for the label. So you note this down for label example. So if I copy the same example and if I paste to create other label, I will put into label 1, that is L1, this is L2. So I change this to second label, but this will not give the second output, right? See, second label, if you execute this one, okay, you will not get, you will get the output as first label, but you are not getting second label. You see now. Okay, so this I have to make, this is L1. Fine. See now. Fine. Again you are getting the output called first label, but I have created second label also, but which is not visible. Why? Because that component I have to add to the frame, correct? So I have not added. So now to get that output, we have to add that. See, add L1. L1 is added. This one is added, correct? So the same way I need to add L2. Whatever the component we have created, that we have to add to the frame. Okay. Now if I execute this part, okay, so I'll get both the labels. See, first label in front of that, second label is coming. Why it is coming in front of this? Because I'm using flow layout. It will set automatically. Okay, this is how we can create label. The third example, which you, if you want, you can create label I. So this one also I will show for your concern. Here we have to set the image icon we need to create first, then we can add that image to the frame. Okay, so I will not call this, I don't want to show this point, but I want to show the icon, how the icon can be visible to the frame. Okay, see now what I will do. I will change this code. I will create one more code, that is L3. I will do fine. Third label, if you want, you can create third label. For that we need to use image icon class to create icon. Why I am copying that? Because if I am writing, that will take a lot of time. So I have already created written code and I will paste that one. See now, this class I am using, that is image icon I, okay, to set the image equals to new image icon. This is the path where my image is there in the computer. This is the path where I have there, I have my image in my computer. So, okay. So now L3 also I need to add L3. Fine. I have added L3. But if you see the L3, what I will do is this, I will cut here and I will paste below this. Okay, L3, fine. Okay. So to show the image icon on the output from the label, so what I have to do, I have already created, written the code for image icon I. This is the instance for the image icon, which equals to new image icon. The path you need to specify, path is users. See here, I have kept the image name is welcome.jpg, which is there in my computer. So now I have to create one more label, J label L3 equals to new J label. Here, what is the third constructor? You can see the third constructor is having. So I am showing the last constructor. You can see string S icon I int horizontal alignment. Okay, this also I can show. But in the last constructor, all these three will come. Okay, so string, yes, I will provide the string. So what I will give you is, here I will put third label. Okay, third label, comma, image icon I have to pass. Icon, see icon I means the instance of the icon or image icon class. What is the instance of the image icon class here? The instance is I. You can see image icon class having the instance is I. So I will put I, comma. Next, horizontal alignment. So what I have to write? Swing, okay, constants dot horizontal. I need to type. See, integer constant will be capital letter always. Swing constant dot horizontal means in which pattern image icon should be shown on the output window. So if I save this, if I execute it, still also you are not getting any output, because you will get only first label and second label. You will not get third label and the image also. You can see now. So if I execute this point, okay, semicolon I have missed. Now you see, once again I will execute this point. See, now I have compiled, right? So now I will execute. So you got the output, first level and second level, but there is no third level and there is no image also. Why? Because again I have not added component to the frame. So I will add L3. So add this L3. So if you add this, you will get the image. Fine. See now. Of course, see. Here welcome is the image which I have added to the frame. And this is first level, second level. You may ask, where is third level? Third level is shifted here. Correct? First level, second label, image icon, and third label. This is how we can use label class. Hope you got an idea about label class. So I have told that before only, you have to note down whatever I was telling. Okay, if you want this example also, you can note this down, because I will go on changing the same example and I will create other components. So this is all about label classes. So if you want, you note this down, okay, in your notebook. So the same example can be changed to the button, radio button, and everything. Fine. Okay, this is all about label class. Fine. So now we have to see some commonly used methods in JLabel. What are the methods? String get text. What it does, if you use this get text method, it returns the text string that label displays. Whatever the label having the name, that name will be displayed in the get text method. If you used set text, you can set the text to the label. Okay, it defines the single line of a text component will display. Set horizontal alignment, now only if you have seen. Get icon, you will get the icon name, okay, or it will display the icon. Get horizontal alignment, it returns the alignment of the labels contained along the x-axis. These are the commonly used methods that you need to keep in your mind. So now let's take an example of JButton. JButton class is used to create a labeled button that has platform independent implementation. This is the abstract button in the class that you have to keep in mind. The application results in a some action when the button is pushed. It innate abstraction or abstract button class. Button JButton inherits from abstract button class. The declaration you can see, public class extends abstract button, okay, implements accessible. This is the class declaration of the JButton. So without further ado, let's discuss with the help of example. The same example I will change, okay, to JButton. Fine. So what I will do is, I will create JButton B equals to new JButton. Okay, if you are confusing, so I will delete all these things. Fine. Okay, from the beginning I will explain. Import java.aw.event class, you need to, event package you need to import. awt.star package you need to import. javax.swing.star package you need to import. This is the class name, the same name I have taken, extends frame. I am inheriting frame. This is the constructor. In the constructor only I am creating the instance of the button component, that is JButton B, okay, equals to new JButton. if you make this empty, you will get the button, but you are not getting anything on the button. Okay, now I have to add this button to the frame. Add, what I need to add here? B. Okay, now I will save this and I will execute this point. So now you see, okay, I am compiling now. See, this is the output of the button. You are seeing now, this is a button, but this button doesn't have any name. Fine. So I am using default constructor to this button. So if you want to put something on the button, or if you want to write something on the button, that constructor needs to be changed. So now I will change that one. J button in the string format, I will write click here. So now I will save this and I will execute this point or this program. Now you see, yes, you got the output called click here. This is the button. How it will operate? It will operate by pushing it. Fine. So now you see J button. Okay, J button having the constructor, default constructor I had already shown. The next, but J button string, now very recently I have executed. So in the button only, or on the button, you can put the image also. Okay, in the label example I had shown how to use the image. So if you want, you can note it down, or you can try this one, the third constructor. But this is enough to write button example. Okay, if you want more buttons, you can create the buttons also. Only one button I am showing. You just note this part now. Whatever you are seeing right now on the screen, example for the J button class. Okay, if you want button and label together also, you can create. So what I will do, I will create label also if you want. J, what I have to write, J label L equals to new J label. Okay, label name whatever you can give. First label, last time this only I had given, right? First label. Okay, now I have to add that label, right? Add, what I need to add? Label, that is L. Save. Now if I execute this part or this program, what I will get is label and buttons, both I will get on the output window. First label also click here, first label click here. These are the two components which are added to the frame. This white background you are seeing, right? This is a frame. Okay, this is all about button classes. So this is about the constructor. Now the commonly used methods for the J button class are like this: set text, get text, set enabled, set select, or set icon, get icon, set mnemonic, add action listener. Set text is used to set the specified text on the button. Okay, fine. Okay, string get text, it used to return the text of the button. Okay, set enabled, boolean b, here it is used to enable or disable the button. If you disable it, you are not getting any output for the button. Set icon, you can set the icon on the button. Get icon, it will return the icon from the button. Set mnemonic, it is used to set the mnemonic on the button. Add action listener, it is used to handle the event. It is used to add the action listener to this object. Fine. So now we have to see J text field. Okay, the object of a J text field class is a text component that allows the editing of a single line text in a J component class. It means that, as we have seen in the J label, it is only allow us to read, or it is only allow the user to read, not to edit. But this J text field allows user to enter the data from the keyboard into the text field. Okay, the class declaration, you can see public class J text field extends J component. This you have to keep in mind. J component implements swing constants. It will only implement swing components. Now the same example I will modify and I will make into. Okay, now already the label is there, J button is there. So then in the same program only I will add text field. Text field T, okay, equals to new text field. But in the method body, I will give the size of the text field, the 10, 20, like that I need to give, 20 if you give, save. And what I have to do, I have to add this, add, what is the text field now, T, add T, fine, save this. And if I compile this one, okay, what I have missed, text field cannot be converted to, okay. So I have written wrong spelling here. I need to write J in front of this J. J. Okay. Now I can execute this one. Fine. No errors are there. So I've got the output. See, first label, click here. This is the text field. You are getting right. This is the label L, button B, text field T. See, you can enter the data also text field. This empty box is known as text field. Now you have to see the constructor of the text field. You can see, okay, first one is default constructor that I have shown. If you are using this, you are not getting, you will get the text field with a very less size, string text. It creates a new text initialized with the specified text. See, second constructor also I will show. Okay, see now the second constructor. In the text field, what I will do is, here I will give some text, default text, okay, GGG, I am saving now. So if I execute this now, we will check whether this will work or not. Hope it will work. See, you are getting the output, but the default content is GGG in the text field, okay. This is the second constructor, you can see. Fine. In the third constructor, J text field, string text, int columns, means number of columns it will be initialized before only. Okay. So the same example I can change. I will put hello, okay, comma, number of columns I will take 3. Constructor is saying int columns, right? Int columns. So 3 is an integer, number of columns, fine. Okay, now I will execute this one. See, you are getting the hello, and you will also get the number of columns, how much you can enter in the hello text field. Okay, this is all about text fields, how to use the text field, fine. Okay, columns are specified but which are empty for the third constructor. J text field int columns, if you give, it will create the empty columns on it. Fine. Commonly used methods are add action listener. So it is used to add the specified action listener to the receive action event from the text field. Means if you are using two text field, in the one text field you will enter one integer and you will enter other integer to the other text field, and you can use these two text fields by action listener, and you can add those data. Okay, get action, it returns the currently set action for the action event source, or null if no action is set. That you can easily understand. Set font, you can set the font. Remove action listener. Okay, this is all about commonly used methods of text field, or J text field you can call.